Hello, my dear students. Good morning. Welcome to the class. See, in the last video, we already discussed about a few types of angles, right? So let us continue with the same topic. So first of all, let us discuss about vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Okay. So look at the statement of vertically opposite angles. Consider two lines AC bar and BD bar which are intersecting at O. So consider the angles angle A and angle C. They have a common vertex O but do not have any common arm. Such angles are called vertically opposite angles. Okay, see, let us consider two lines. Suppose these are the two lines. Line 1 is AC and line 2 is BD. And both are intersecting at a point O. Now consider the angles small a and small c. Angle A and angle C. Here let it be suppose this is small angle A and this is angle C. So what can you say about these two angles, angle A and angle C? See, these two angles have a common vertex O, but they don't have any common arm, is it not? So this is the arm, OB, OC are the arms for angle A, whereas OA and OD are the arms for angle C. So these two angles have only common vertex O, but they don't have any common arm. Then such angles are called vertically opposite angles. And you know, my dear, if suppose this angle you consider as angle B and this is as angle D. Now see, look at here, these two are also having common vertex O but having no common arm. Hence, we can say that angle B and angle D are also vertically opposite angles. And you know, my dear, vertically opposite angles are equal. Hence, I can say that here angle A is equals to angle C and angle B is equals to angle D since they are vertically opposite angles. Next, regarding supplementary angles, see, two angles are said to be supplementary, if their sum is equals to 180 degrees. If sum of the two angles is equals to 180 degrees, then we can say that those two angles are supplementary angles. You know, for example, suppose two angles are 20 degrees and 160 degrees. See, whose sum is 180, you know? Hence, 20 degrees and 160 degrees, together we call them as a supplementary angles, since their sum is equals to 180 degrees. In the same way, I can say that 30 degrees and 150 degrees, even 45 and 135 degrees, etc. See, all these pair of angles are said to be supplementary angles because whose sum is equals to supplementary is equals to 180 degrees. So coming to complementary angles. Complementary angles. See, two angles are said to be complementary if their sum is equals to 90 degrees. Okay, so two angles are said to be complementary angles whose sum is equals to 90 degrees. For example, see, example 20 degrees comma 70 degrees. See, 20 plus 70, which is equals to 90. And this pair of angles can be considered as complementary angles. And in the same way, you can also go with 30 degrees and 60 degrees, 45 degrees, even 45 degrees, etc. etc. are an examples of complementary angles. Next, intersecting lines. Anybody know what is the definition of intersecting lines? Or else, when can we say that two lines are intersecting lines? See, if two lines have a common point, then the lines are intersecting lines. And the common point is called point of intersection. See, for example, let it be the line 1, L1 is equals to 0. Let it be the line 2, L2 is equals to 0. Now you see, these two lines having a common point, which is P. I mean, P is a point which is lies on line 1 as well as line 2. I mean, P is the common point for both the line 1 and the line 2. Hence, since they have a common point, then the lines are said to be intersecting lines. And the common point here, P, is called as point of intersection. Okay, next, concurrent lines. See children, just now we discussed, you know, if two lines are having a common point or else two lines are passing through the same point. Okay, now coming to here, if three or more lines, three or more lines are having same common point, then the lines are called concurrent lines, and the common point is called point of concurrence. Point of concurrence. Okay, see here, three or more lines. See, in case of only two lines, then you know the point P is called only point of intersection, and moreover the lines are said to be intersecting lines because of only two lines. If three or more lines are having the same common point. See here, for example, these are the lines, not only three or not only four, that's why we gave the common statement that if three or more lines, yeah, definitely here more than three or even more than three, all these lines are having the common point as a P. I mean, all the lines are passing through the same point, which is P. Hence, the lines are said to be concurrent lines, and the point P is said to be point of concurrence. Next, coming to parallel lines. Two lines, say some L and M, are said to be parallel if they lie on the same plane and having no common point. Clear? See, two lines, suppose say L and M, are said to be parallel if they lie on the same plane and having no common point. They should not have any common point. So this is the situation. Say for example, so this is a line, suppose L, and this is the another line M. Both must be lie in the same plane and they should not have any common point. Then both of these lines are said to be parallel lines. Okay, and moreover can be represented like this. So read it as L parallel to M, means both the lines L and M are parallel lines. Okay, ma. And moreover, what is the angle between them? So, angle between two parallel lines is 0, isn't it? Because they never meet each other, they never intersect each other. Hence, two lines are said to be parallel. One way we can also consider that if the angle between them is 0. Next, I think everybody knows that regarding perpendicular lines, two lines are said to be perpendicular if the angle between them is 90 degrees. See, these are the two lines. One is L and this is M. And see, L and M both are perpendicular to each other since angle between them is a right angle, 90 degrees. Okay, ma? And next, regarding coincident lines. Two lines having infinitely many common points. Then the lines are called coincident lines. Two lines having infinitely many common points, then they are called coincident lines. Okay, so for example, assume that P, Q, R, S are some points here. So now listen here, line PS and QS. PS and QS are the two lines having infinitely many common points, isn't it? So having infinitely many common points, that's why PS and QS are coincident lines. So, coming to transversal line. So, look at the definition. Transversal line is nothing but a straight line which intersects two or more given lines. At different points is called a transversal line, or simply transversal. See, for example, let it be the line 1, let it be the line 2. Now, this is the line, say some L, which is intersecting the first line at P and second line at Q. Then, the line L is said to be a transversal, because transversal nothing but a straight line which is intersecting two or more lines, given lines, at different points. Yeah, why not? Isn't it? So, this is the line L, which is intersecting the two or even more lines at different points, and the line is said to be a transversal. and suppose this is the one more example. So suppose these are the two lines, okay, or say suppose three lines. Now this is the line, say some M, which is intersecting the given lines at different points ABC, isn't it, ma? So here M is the line which is intersecting the given lines at different points. So very simple that in the situation 1 L and in the situation 2 M are transversal lines. So L and M are transversal lines. So coming to intercept, see what is the definition of intercept. Consider any two lines L and M. See, suppose this is the line L and say suppose this is the line M. Yeah, consider any two lines L and M and a transversal N intersecting. See, suppose this is the transversal line which is N intersecting the lines at capital A and capital B respectively. Then the distance between A and B, this distance is there, no? The distance between A and B is called simply intercept, or length of the intercept also we can treat it. So next is about classification of angles formed by a transversal. Right, children? Just now we discussed, you know, regarding the definition of a transversal line. So based on the transversal line, we can classify the angles into few types. In that first one, alternate angles. So let us see, when can we say that two angles are alternate angles? So two angles are said to be alternate angles if point number one, they are on the either side of a transversal. If they are on the either side of the transversal. And one more point is that both are interior angles and can be exterior angles also. And the most important point is they are not adjacent angles. We already discussed about adjacent angles in the last video, right, children? See, regarding the alternate angles, when can we say that the two angles are alternate? See, they must be lie on the either side of the transversal. Otherwise, both angles can be interior angles or both angles can be exterior angle. And see, they are not adjacent angles. See, for example, this is the situation. Say, L and M are the two lines. And say, suppose N is the transversal cut. N is the transversal line, isn't it? Can consider it as a transversal cut. And suppose, let us denote that this is angle 1, 2, 3 and 4. Or else take like this, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now can you guess here which pair of angles are alternate angles? And look at that one. Before that, this we can also treat them as alternate interior angles and alternate exterior angles also. So let us see what is the definition of alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. This is not just now we discussed, no? Either both are maybe interior or both are maybe exterior angles. If they are interior, then we say that alternate interior angles. So the pairs of angles on regarding alternate interior angles. See, basically alternate angles means they must be lie on the either side of the transversal. Either side of the transversal. One side and other side. Either side of the transversal. And in that both angles can be exterior and can be interior angles also. And moreover they are not at all adjacent angles. So look at that in alternate angles. What are the alternate interior angles? See, the pair of angles opposite sides of the transversal, okay, because of this is no either side, nothing but opposite side of the transversal, and but lies inside the two lines, then they are called alternate interior angles. See, for example, here look at angle 3 and angle 6. See, angle 3 and angle 6 are lies on the either side of the transversal. 3 is on one side and 6 is on other side of the transversal. And moreover, actually 3 and 6 are no doubt alternate angles. And moreover, see, 3 and 6 are the two angles which lies inside of two lines. Inside the. That's why either side. That's why we call it as a, because of they lie on the either side of transversal, we call them as alternate angles. And moreover, both are lies inside the two lines. Hence, we can call them as alternate interior angles. So, see, for example, here coming to example, alternate interior angles. See, what are the alternate interior angles? Angle 3 and angle 6. Moreover, what about 4 and 5? See, these are also 4 and 5 are also lies on the either side of the transversal to the line N. Is it no? This is one side and 4 is other side. And moreover, both are lies inside of two lines. And so I can also say that other pair is angle 4 and angle 5. Okay, so basically they are lying on the either side of the transversal lines. We can call them as alternate angles basically. But moreover, the two pairs are lies inside the lines. Hence we can call them as pair of alternate interior angles. Okay, alternate interior angles are okay. And similarly, can you tell me alternate exterior angles here? Exterior angles. And before that, let us see what are the alternate exterior angles. The pairs of angles on opposite side of the transversal, yes, no doubt, but outside the lines, see, outside the two lines, then they are called exterior angles. See, now what can we say about angle 1 and angle 8? See, angle 1 and angle 8. See, 1 and 8, since they are basically lie on the either side of the or opposite side of the transversal, yes, no doubt, they are alternate angles. And moreover, you see, 1 is out of the first line, even 8 is out of the second line. I mean, 1 and 8 are lies outside of the two lines. Hence, this pair is treated as pair of alternate exterior angles. And can you tell me one more pair like 1 and 8, 2 and 7, 2 and 7, 2, angle 2 and angle 7. So, this is also one more pair which lies either side of the transversal and moreover completely, I mean, out of the two lines. So, next, corresponding angles. Two angles are said to be a pair of corresponding angles. See, if they lie on the same side of the earlier, either side, that is opposite side. But now here, they lie on the same side of the transversal. And moreover, you see, one is interior angle and the other is exterior angle. And they are not adjacent angles. See, let us consider the once again the same situation. L and M are two lines. Let N be the transversal line. Okay, these are the angles 1, 2, 3, 4. And let them 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now let us see here angle 1 and angle 5. Angle 1 and angle 5. You see, these are considered as a corresponding angles. Why? Because they both are lies on the same side. Okay. And moreover, one is interior angle. See, 5 is the interior angle, but 1 is the exterior angle. And moreover, they are not even adjacent angles. So, 1 and 5. Moreover, angle 2 and angle 6 are corresponding angles. These are corresponding, pair of corresponding angles also we can call them. Okay, ma. See, they both must lie on the same side. And one should be interior and the other one should be exterior. And see that they both are not adjacent angles also. See, coming to co-interior angles. See, co-interior angles are also called allied angles. See, very simple, ma. The pair of angles which are interior, is it not? Because here itself, co-interior, both are interior. See, the pair of angles which are interior and on the same side of the transversal. Right, children? Both must be interior, point number one. And the second one must be on the same side of the transversal are called allied angles. And you know, the sum of co-interior angles is equals to 180 degrees where lines must be parallel. So see here, especially angle 3 and angle 5, both are on the same side and both are interior. and even 4 and 6 are also lie on the same side of transversal and which lies in the interior of the two lines. So hence angle 3 and angle 5, angle 4 and angle 6 are an examples of allied angles which are also called co-interior angles. Okay children, and please note the point number 1. Point number 1, if alternate angles are equal, suppose alternate angles are equal, then the lines are parallel. Okay, in the same way, point number 2, if corresponding angles are also equal, then also the lines are parallel. Right children? So please go through the concepts once again, and you must be good at the definition as well as concept of each and every terminology, so that you can solve the problems very easily. So try to learn all these definitions as early as possible. Okay. Thank you.